and welcome to Moreland Makerspace Online. My name's Anna, and I'm going to be taking you through a tutorial of the online photo editor program, Pixlr. This is the project we're going to be doing today, and this project involves many of the basic and useful tools within the program. Before we start, I want you to make sure that you have downloaded the three files, the gum leaves, the kangaroo, and the Melbourne cityscape, which are available for download on the online makerspace. When you're ready, we're going to come up and we're going to open our internet browser. So Pixlr is an in-browser program, so anybody with an internet connection can use it. And I want you to type in pixlr.com. And you should get a screen like this. Now, when you open Pixlr, you want to select Advanced Pixlr E. And from here, we're going to go Open Image. Once you've opened Image, I want you to find where you've saved those three files. And you can select more than one image at once to open them. To do so, you want to click, hold down Shift on your keyboard, and then click the other two images, and you should see that they're all highlighted. When they're all highlighted, just click Open. Now, you'll notice that they've all opened up into separate tabs. So the separate tabs work like tabs on the internet. So it means that we can work on all of these items individually. They're all on what we call their own canvases. Okay. The first one we're going to be working on is gum leaves. So I want you to open up the gum leaves tab. Sometimes when you open an image, it can appear large or small. If it's going outside of the space that you can view, I'm going to introduce you to the first tool that can help with that. Over here is the toolbar. This toolbar contains all sorts of tools. The great thing about Pixlr is when you hover over a tool, it'll give you a little explanation and example of what that tool does. So if we want to enlarge or minimize an object on our screen, we simply click, and you can either go plus or minus. These are the modes for the tools that come along here. So if there's any different options for the tools, you'll find them in the top bar across the top. And I'm going to click minus, and I'm going to click once so that I can see the whole picture. The tool that we're going to be using the gum leaves on is the one called One Select. One Select allows you to select similar colors to each other. So the computer will be able to tell what is white and what is green. What we're trying to do is isolate the gum leaves from their background. So we need to select the background so we can delete it. So I'm going to come up here and click One Select, and it should go light gray when it's selected. And I'm just going to click once on the white. Now when I click on the white, you'll notice that quite a lot of the white has been selected, but not all of it. What we can do to tell the computer that we want more of the white selected is change what we call the tolerance. What I'm going to do now is on my keyboard, I'm going to click, for me I'm on a Mac, so I'm going to say Command Z, but you might say Control Z if you're on Windows, and that's for undo. So to change the tolerance, what we're going to do is we're going to come up here and I'm going to bring it up to about 70. So this is just telling the computer, I want you to tolerate more kinds of white. So that means that in this picture, because it's not pure white, the computer recognizes the different colors. But if we make the tolerance a little bit higher, it should recognize more of the shades of white. So now if I come down and click here, you'll notice that the vast majority of the white has been picked up. But there's still a little bit of white missing from the selection here. So if I want to add to the selection, I need to come back up to Options. And then there's a mode here called Add to Selection. I'm going to click that, and that allows me to pick up just that little bit of white that was left. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to press Delete on my keyboard, and all the white will disappear. Now if you want the selection box to disappear as well, on your keyboard you can go Command or Control D, and that's for deselect. Now you'll notice that these checkerboards have appeared. These checkerboards indicate transparency. So the thing to think about transparency, if you're not familiar with it, think of it like a window and a window pane. If you've got the wooden cross coming across a window pane that you can't see through, that's the gum leaves. But then the pane of glass, it's transparent. That's what these checkerboards are indicating. So showing now that the gum leaves has no background. What we're going to do now is I'm going to come up and I'm going to select the Marquee Select tool. This is a great tool for just selecting a large area. All you need to do is click and drag across. Don't have to be particularly accurate. It will snap back to the size of the canvas. And there we've got that selected. Now, by now, you might be experiencing the same thing I am, which is an ad. If you want to get rid of an ad, just click this X in the far right corner. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to come up to go to edit, and I'm going to go edit and copy, and we're going to come across to the Melbourne Cityscape. Now my Melbourne Cityscape's open quite small, so I'm going to have to use the magnifying glass tool again, the zoom tool. Make sure it's on plus and click that a few times so I can see what I'm doing. Then I'm going to come up to edit and click paste. And you should see here that the gum leaf has been pasted. And you can see that Melbourne can be seen behind the gum leaf. And that's because the gum leaf's background was transparent. Now the gum leaf is very big. What I'm going to do is I'm going to come and use a tool called arrange. And arrange allows you to move things and change their size. So when I click arrange, it selected the gum leaf. One of the reasons it selected the gum leaf is because the gum leaf layer has been selected. What layers are in this window over here, and they're one of the most useful features of any video editing tool. It allows you to work on separate items within the one picture independently. So as you can see from the preview here, this little one here is the gum leaf and the one below is Melbourne. When I want to work on gum leaf, I need to make sure that this layer is selected. Because it's called something a bit funny, we can rename it. What you want to do is click on the three little dots, which are the layer settings, and we can change the name to gum leaves. This makes it a bit easier to know what we're working with. But the way that layers work is, imagine you've got a collage. You've cut out multiple magazine clippings and you're layering them on top of each other. The one on the top will be overlapping the ones underneath. That's how layers work. Sometimes if you're trying to edit a particular part of a picture and your edit isn't working, often the main reason for that is that you're not working on the right layer. So you've not got the right layer selected. When a layer is selected, it'll pop up this kind of teal color, and you'll know you're on the right one. Back to the Arrange tool. With the Arrange tool, you'll see that it's brought up this square around the gum leaves. These shapes in the corner allow us to resize and reorientate the object. So I'm just going to click and drag and bring this one down to about here, about this size. You can also click in the middle, and then you're able to move your object around that way. To reorientate, simply bring your cursor up here and you'll notice a little hand appears on the circle, and then you can drag that round in a circle until you've got your object orientated in the way that you want it to be. Might make that a little bit smaller. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to drag this up into the top corner. And that's our first gum leaf done. Now you'll notice in our example that there were multiple gum leaves. And the way that we achieve that is by duplicating. To duplicate a layer, what you want to do is make sure that you've got it selected. So I've got the Arrange tool selected. I'm on the right layer. I'm going to come back to the object itself and I'm going to right click. When I right click, it brings up these options and I'm going to click Duplicate Layer. Now at first, if we're just looking here, nothing looks different. But if I come across to the layers window over here, you can see that there's now a copy of gum leaves, and that is the selected layer. So if I come over and I click and I drag, you'll notice now that I've got two visible gum leaves. So that's how you duplicate a layer and create a copy, which will appear on your canvas. What I'm going to do is I'm going to now show you how to make a object mirrored, so to change its orientation in another way. I'm going to right click and duplicate layer again. I'm going to drag it over to the corner here, and from here I'm going to do something else. I'm going to use the menu up here. I'm going to go edit and then transform. This is another way to rotate your objects, but it also gives you the option to flip them horizontally or vertically. We want to flip it horizontally to mirror the gum leaf. When I click that, you'll notice that these are now facing each other. One more step, we're going to right click, duplicate layer again. We're going to drag gum leaf back here. Actually, we might make sure that this one's in the front and then this one can come to the back. Notice that the two ones in the middle are in the front and the ones on the farther edge are in the back. Another nice effect that can be really effective is playing with transparency. So before, when we talked about transparency, it was talking about the background being completely gone, but we can actually make things appear kind of sheer and somewhat see-through. And the way to do that is with the Arrange tool, click on the object that you want to change the transparency on. So you notice I've clicked this back gum leaf here, which has meant that this layer has been highlighted. And then what we do is we click the three dots, so the layer settings here on the layer that's been selected. And there's a little toggle here that allows us to change the transparency. So I'm just going to bring that down to about 60 or so. And once I click out of that, you'll notice that the buildings have started to show through this gum leaf. So it's no longer fully solid. It's become sheer and semi-transparent. And this can just be a really nice effect to use in your projects. I'm just going to do that to the gum leaf on the other side. So I'm going to come across, make sure the Arrange tool is selected, click on that gum leaf. You'll notice that its layers become highlighted here, which is really handy to know which one's which. I'm going to click into layer settings and then drag that down to about 60. So there's some really useful tools to know how to manipulate the images that you have in Pixlr. So you can change the appearance of what you've got. The next thing we're going to bring into the Melbourne postcard is the kangaroo. So we're going to come up to the kangaroo tab up here. Now, something to notice is that the kangaroo is very similar to its coloured background. So we can't use the wand select tool. If I was to use the wand select tool, I'll demonstrate here. If I was to click on the background, hoping it would select the background like it did for the gum leaves, you'll notice that nearly all of the kangaroo, other than its black eyes, nose, and mouth, are fully selected. That's because the computer doesn't know the difference between what is kangaroo and what is the background. It just doesn't have enough difference in color or tone. So I'm going to press Command D to deselect. So this is where I introduce you to another tool for cutting out objects from their backgrounds that are maybe too complex a shape for the computer to pick up, or the colors are too similar. We're going to be using what we call the cutout or mask tool. The reason why I like this tool is it allows you to choose what you want to cut out. So you can omit anything that you don't want, or you can add anything you do. While if you're using the one select tool, it's up to the computer. I'm going to have to change the mode a bit on this tool for this project. So I'm going to come up here and I'm going to select the draw mask. This gives me a little paintbrush. If you notice, I've got the little circle here on my cursor. It gives me a little paintbrush that I can draw around the object to cut it out from its background. I'm going to change the brush size, make it a little bit larger. So to do so, I come up to where it says brush. I click on the little downwards triangle here, and I'm just going to bring the size up to about 80. And then click off. Notice now that my brush is a bit bigger. This is the part that takes a little bit of time, and you do have to be careful because you are doing it manually. But just to know that if you do make any mistakes, all you need to do is press Command Z or Control Z on your keyboard to undo any mistakes. To demonstrate what we're doing, you'll notice as I move my mouse around the kangaroo, so we're trying to cut out the kangaroo as if we had a pair of scissors, it's starting to paint red. When I unclick, so I let go of my mouse, you'll notice that the transparency is now there. So that means that we're starting to cut the kangaroo out from its background. I'm just going to spend a bit of time now working my way around the kangaroo. Okay, so now I've cut around the entirety of the kangaroo, but we still have a little bit of the background on either side and above. Just going to zoom out a little bit so I can make sure I can see the whole picture. But I'm just going to grab the mask tool again. I'm going to make the brush a little bit larger. I'm just going to spend some time getting rid of that background here. Okay, there we go. Kangaroo has been removed from its background. Before we copy across to the Melbourne cityscape though, there's another step we have to do. You'll notice that there's a little pair of scissors that shows up on the kangaroo layer here. That shows that this tool has been applied. When we copy it across the way that we copied the gum leaves across, it won't carry that tool application across. So to make sure that it does and that the background remains transparent, we need to come to the three dots to layer settings and we need to click flatten image. Notice that the scissors have disappeared. What that means now is that the computer doesn't recognize that there was ever a tool applied. So it just means it doesn't get confused when we go to copy it across. If you ever go to copy something across and it hasn't worked the way that you wanted it to, it might be that flattening the image will help. What I'm going to do is now come up to Marquee Select. I'm going to pull it across. I'm going to go Edit and Copy and come into Melbourne Cityscape again. Then we're going to go Edit and Paste. We've got our kangaroo. Again, it's probably a bit too large, so click the Arrange tool and you'll see these boxes come up. Click and drag and make the kangaroo whatever size you think looks good in the picture. Okay, so that's our project done. You've learned a couple of the selection tools and you've learned how to edit some of the images individually in Pixlr with the transform tool and the transparency and how to reorientate and move objects. And you've also learned a bit about layers. These are some of the most useful tools in Pixlr and some of the most basic. What we're going to do now is the final part of a project, which is saving it. I'm going to go up to File and I'm going to go Save. Call it what you will. It allows you to change what file type and what quality you want. And then press Download. You'll see here that your image should have downloaded into your downloads folder on your computer. And that's it. That's the end of our tutorial today. Thank you so much for watching along. I do have some further resources that I've made, some written ones that should be available in the Moreland Makerspace online, and they go through what we went through in the tutorial today. So if you'd like to recap on anything, please feel free to utilize those. Thank you so much.